So this is interesting. So I was looking up old maps of Michigan, and seeing what, find out some kind of history of Michigan, and we know very little about this state, because, I mean, check this map out right here. This map here, they didn't know much about the state. They knew about around the Detroit area, it looked like, but I don't even think Detroit was here, because I don't see it written on the map. And see, none of the counties or anything are in this map. There's no counties in Michigan at all. This map is from 1822. And mostly belonged to the natives, I'm guessing, Native Americans. But then I found this map. Now that looks more like a modern map. That's a whole lot closer now to modern map. And here you see it's got all the counties and everything in it. And the date on this was, I believe, near the bottom two. Oh, here we go, 1874. So they moved in here pretty quick. It didn't take them very many years to go from not knowing anything to completely taking over and naming everything in the state. They just moved in, and I can't imagine them going in and just having the natives, Potawatomi that were in the area, and what other tribes. I don't know all the tribes that were up here, but I can't imagine them just agreeing to that. Okay. So they come into my area and 1840, they were just exploring this area. As they were moving up here, they were learning about it. And it even shows right here where they came in and changed the name of Carawatabet, the Indian chief of the Potawatomi tribe, and changed it to Wexford County. So, and so like right from the beginning, they're trying to just wipe out any history that was here. And I have heard stories about this area that, and of course, everything that they've seen was, well, the Indians did it, and they didn't even come in and have archaeologists come in and examine to see if, you know, they just assumed that they did it. But how did they do some of this stuff? Because they have two lakes in this town, and there's a story a friend of mine reminded me of, and maybe I can find out more about that story. I've heard it before in the past where they had to move the logs between the two lakes, and there's a canal that they had to build this canal. Apparently, there were some kinds of tunnels under the lakes or between them or something that, of course, the story is the Indians built, but I never heard of Indians building stuff like that before. And then there's the passageways that are under this town that there's an entrance from the courthouse into them. There's an entrance from one of the main buildings downtown. Who knows where all they go, but was that something that they built when they came up here, or did they just find it and build over it? It's crazy. But anyway, supposedly they had to destroy that one structure in order to move their logs between the lakes or something, and that's what they did. And they just said, well, yeah, we don't care that, you know, it was just some stupid Indian thing, you know, we're just going to bust right through it. And tomorrow I'm going to go back out to up to Diggins, because I had spotted a place with a big old fire pit with gigantic rocks that they built up there. It looks like a megalithic thing, but it's all cemented in. And well, I want to do a story on that. I'm going to go and take some pictures of it. But and anyway, here we are, Michigan now. And what I've done here is this is a Lake Cadillac, of course, named after the guy who founded Detroit. His last name was Cadillac. I believe he was a French explorer. And he founded Detroit and came up here and then founded this area, apparently, and then named it Cadillac. And so there's a lake named after him, and then there's a lake named after Mitchell. This is Lake Mitchell. And then over here is Diggins Hill. And all this area is a park, Diggins Park, what they're calling Diggins Park. Their main attraction is a tennis court right here. If you go to their site, there's a Diggins Park community site, and that's their main attraction. They don't even understand what they have up there. I marked all these rocks here, and there's a gigantic rock right here that we found under the trees when my son and my daughter-in-law were up there with me. I never remember seeing that. Maybe I've seen it once before, because I had to, but it's been there a long time. So I found, just tootling around here, and I marked some of the other rocks. There's the Mayan stone, and then there's a rock cut that was had been partially chiseled on, and then the Sleeping Dragon Head, which I decided to call it, is right here, a little over 200 feet. And there's two paths here. There's one that goes along this way, which is the first path that I took out here when I was looking for this one rock that turned out to be a head. I walked all the way through here and then ended up finding it coming back this way. And then I didn't realize which way I came in, and it took me a long time to find it again, but now I've got it located. I've got the GPS location of this and a few other locations. One here outside the tennis court. It's got several rocks in it, and I found some other large rocks and was able to identify them. And these two here, you see all this stuff here? There's some crazy stuff. I got some pictures off in this area too, and this is the edge of the land here. And there's a that big fire pit in here, and there's a picture of it near the end of or in my other last video. But I want to go back out there and take some more pictures of the rocks that the guy used on his fire pit. So anyway, anyone wants the GPS address of any of these rocks, I'll probably post them on another video, but I've got to keep my videos fairly under control. So I'm going to end this one now. So long, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to me if you haven't already. And share my videos.